Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
Me to the roosters. In prison, the first time grandfather asked to go to the cock's house, but no one expected why. The most healing thing I ever found out was realizing the same God who I was begging for help was the same God who inflicted the damage in the first place. And I realized that there was no God and I didn't need him or her to make me strong. My friends changed my life and I cannot curb my urge to write that. Without my friends, I am not what I am now. By the way, one of my friends introduced Quora to me and Quora changed my life. My friends are the God's gift. Most of the real experiences that I have had of God, I did not realize what they were until much later. I would say, in the main, that the only time I have gotten a feeling of something supernatural, it has been evil, and it has been God letting me know that what I was about to do was not something that I should have been doing. My personal experience tells me God is pure love, so pure hate, evil, or violence cannot enter or connect with God. It's humanity that created the devil, hate, and evil. Humanity needs an excuse for its evil, so humanity tells us God is omnipotent and omniscient. God is the creator, and the creation has the freedom to destroy, which it does quite well. Initially, it was the Jesus story more than his father, God. I was moved as a child by the stories. As a teen, I stopped thinking about those stories, but I knew and I could repeat them if asked. At 18, in college, I had a close encounter with the Grim Reaper, suicide, and was pulled back by my childhood memories of Jesus and his words. I was forever changed after that close encounter. It indelibly sealed a faith plus hope meets an experience in my mind, heart, and soul. It's really not possible to forget or diminish the significance of a life-saving experience. I was and am a changed person. When the cell door was opened, the nervous old man, Vasily, entered and saluted the prisoners who were still sitting there, but no one answered him. A man with a long beard and tattoos on his face and arms demanded that Vasily sit on the chair in the corner of the cell. The strong man, Boris, felt sorry when he saw a man in his 90s enter prison and did not want to treat him as harshly as he does with the rest of the prisoners. Vasily asked the prison director to take him to the cell with the most dangerous criminals, a request that made the prison director surprised. The prison director immediately asked the old man why he had chosen to stay with these dangerous people, but the grandfather did not answer him and kept begging him. The prison director agreed to the strange request of the old man, who asked him about the crime he had committed to be imprisoned. Vasily told him that he noticed that there were young men who came from the city to the village in a luxury car, and they brought tents, food, wine, and some other things. They spent their time playing and dancing, and when they left the trash in the forest and didn't collect it, which caused a bad smell from the place, and the trash piled up everywhere. The old man approached these young men several times and asked that they collect the waste that they leave on the ground. They disfigured the beautiful forest, but they did not fulfill his request, and each time they mocked and laughed at him. Then the man became angry and decided to stop them in any way, as he is a former soldier in the Russian army and fought many wars. He felt humiliated when these young men treated him this way because he had never been so humiliated in the many years that he had lived. Vasily filed a complaint against these young men, but the police could not stop them because the young people had too much influence. When the old man noticed that there was no one standing in the face of the young men, he decided to deal in his own way, as he waited for them. They parked the car in the usual place and went out for a walk in the woods, then he brought gasoline and set the car on fire and went home. The young people were surprised when they saw the car burning, and they immediately confirmed that the old man did it, so the owner of the car told his father what Vasily had done. In turn, the rich man sued the old man and in the end managed to get him to prison and was fined. The director of the prison was moved when he heard the story of the old man, who could not hold back his tears as he recounted what had happened. He agreed to his demand, ordering the guards to take him to the cell of the dangerous prisoners and ordering them to be careful and to intervene in case the prisoners were assaulted. Vasily kept walking between the cells of the criminal prisoners and then asked the two guards to take him to a cell that was at the end of the corridor. There he entered the cell where Boris was staying and tried to remain calm. The old man chose two young men from among the four men who resided in the cell and offered them to help him escape from prison. He promised them that he had a plan that would enable them to get out of prison safely. Indeed, the old man and his companions managed to get out of the prison through a secret hatch that was located in the cell so that the two prisoners found themselves outside the prison. Vasily went with the two prisoners to the village and immediately went to the church. There he stopped in front of her and told them that he was the one who built that church with his father after the end of the Second World War. They have been calling people to pray for all these years until he was arrested by the police. The old man asked the two young men to enter the church, and there he put on the priest's clothes and started wiping with his right hand on the head of each one of them. Then the two prisoners felt great psychological comfort and sat on the ground and kept praying to the Lord. Meanwhile, Vasily went up to the top of the church and rang the bells several times. The villagers were astonished when they heard the church bells ringing after it had stopped for several months, during which time Vasily spent in prison. Then all the villagers, excited, went to the church to pray because the sound of the bells made them feel that God was calling them to prayer. Vasily spent that night with the two young men who escaped from prison and took advantage of those moments to hear them some of the words written in the Bible. The two young men noticed a lot of interaction with those words and felt great comfort and told him that they regretted many evil deeds and that they were ready to repent to the Lord to forgive them. The policemen came and surrounded the church. Then they were surprised by the two prisoners who were quietly leaving and surrendered to the policemen. Meanwhile, Vasily asked the policemen to wait for him until the church bells ring again and then surrender. Vasily kept ringing the bells for 5 minutes, and the sound of the bells spread everywhere, which made the policemen forget about the prisoners and approach the church to perform prayers there. Vasily returned with the two young men to prison, and as soon as the prison director saw them, he approached the old man and asked him why he escaped from prison in this way. Vasily smiled and told him that he had taken two of the most dangerous prisoners in that prison to show them their need for prayer in their lives. This will make them get rid of the evil within them and become good people after they leave prison. Meanwhile, the chief of police, who had brought the three men to prison, intervened. He told the director that what Vasily had done in the church was magic, and he made them enter the church to pray. The prison director realized that the old man in front of him was a priest and had been serving the church for decades, so he decided to do everything in his power to get him out of prison. The director noticed that the behavior of the two dangerous prisoners had completely changed, and they became calm and waiting for their prison term to end in order to get out and start a new life. Then he realized that Vasily was serious. That is why he called him to his office and asked him what he had done with the two prisoners so that their behavior might change in that way. Vasily said that anyone in this world needs time to draw near to the Lord and pray. He will make his heart get rid of the evil within him, and he pointed to the dangerous prisoners who languish in the cells and said that they are originally good people and all who lack time to pray and draw near to the Lord. In a short time they will come to their senses and become good people, as is the case with the common people. Vasily stayed for days, moving between the prison cells, reading the Bible to the prisoners, and offering spiritual lessons that would make them draw closer to the Lord. Over time, everyone liked to watch his lectures and listen carefully, including the prison guards. The director of the prison worked in secret until he was finally able to prove Vasily's innocence, and this is after all the case is for a well-known lawyer. The old man was granted parole and could return to serve the church as he had done before. Before the man left the church, he asked the director to gather the prisoners in the prison yard and instructed them to visit the church as soon as they leave the prison. It helps them a lot to open a new page in their lives, and they will not return to the wrong behaviors in their lives. The man concluded his words by saying that life is short and a person must enjoy it, and the pleasure begins only by approaching the Lord and praying. The old man made a real revolution inside the prison and made the criminals realize that they had a chance with the Lord, who would inevitably accept their repentance. This is why they all insisted on changing their view of life immediately after their release from prison. The old man got out of prison and returned to the church, which he spent most of his life in the service of, and began to give lessons in the various prisons in the province in which he lives. The man also made sure to ring the bells every day. Vasily only lived 6 months after his release from prison, where he died and left the church, which he served in his soul. The fates decreed that the two young men who escaped with the Vasili get out of prison and immediately went to the church to meet the old man, and when they learned that he had died, they felt very sad and decided to take his place in that church. The two young men decided to retire from life and devote themselves to serving the Lord as they became volunteers in the church, helping people and calling them to prayer. I believe God guides me through life, through my actions and decisions, both right and wrong. One thing that God did that changed my life was allowing a sort of misfortune to happen to me where a person on the internet wronged me and behaved badly toward me. After that incident, I learned from my mistakes and I stopped playing video games for good, a sort of addiction I had which made it difficult to pursue things I wanted to do and take myself to a healthier, more productive direction. Ever since then, I began exercising every day, and in just 2 months, I had a tremendous improvement in my endurance and strength. I focused more on my studies, my personal projects, and even my personality became tougher and more robust in the face of bad luck, mistakes, and injustice done to me by others. God wants man to be happy, but in a good way, and just like a parent may take a harder stance toward their child to teach it and make it learn to behave in the correct way, so too God allows misfortune to strike us every once in a while because He knows it will ultimately benefit us, assuming we ourselves are willing to learn and come out better because of it. God, who loves man infinitely, only wants what's good for us, and sometimes He'll give us medicine with a more bitter taste so we can be cured from our spiritual diseases.
Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.